Alright guys, we are back in my garage for another video, and today we're going to be talking about the oil level sensor in our BMWs. I know this is kind of a big point of contention because a lot of people hate that we don't have dipsticks anymore, and we have these oil level sensors that we have to rely on instead to tell us if our oil level is okay. And especially being a German car, there are a lot of concerns with oil consumption and oil leaks. So it seems like this puts us at a really big risk. And then of course now, especially in the TU engines, we're hearing about oil pump issues and problems with being able to even measure your oil. So where does this really all come together? You know, how does the sensor work? Why does an oil pump cause the oil sensor not to work anymore? And what do you really need to know about the oil level sensor to make sure you're not having any issues with yours? So in this video, we're going to talk about all of that. I've been trying to do more research over the past several weeks, and I feel like I've got a better grasp of how it actually works and functions. So I'm going to share this information with you guys just so you have a little bit of peace of mind and how it operates. So let's go ahead and talk about it, and hopefully you guys find this video useful. Now, as always, for everybody that's new to the channel, I create these videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments in our community, as well as discuss technical topics so that we have a better understanding of how our engines work. So if you're interested in more videos like that, be sure to subscribe because there will be a lot more coming out in the future. Now, one thing that my research revealed is that the oil level sensor wasn't primarily a cost savings activity from BMW's standpoint. The biggest reason why they needed to implement it was to support Vanos. And I made a video a while ago talking about Vanos, but for anybody that hasn't seen that or isn't familiar, Vanos is how BMW implements variable cam timing. So it uses oil pressure inside of variable cam gears, and that controls the actual cam timing so you can monitor and change when your valves open and close. So this gives you the best power when you need it, but also the best efficiency when you don't need the extra power, and kind of can blend the best of both worlds. Now, like a lot of things on German cars, in particular BMWs, it is a pretty complicated system. And so it was important for BMW to understand certain specifications and characteristics of the oil in order to properly calibrate and control the Vanos system. And so a big part of that was knowing the oil level. And so that required adding an oil level sensor that could send data to the DME to control how much oil was going to those cam gears. And so that's where the oil level sensor came from. Of course, at that point, they determined a dipstick was pretty redundant, so it ended up being removed from a lot of their engines. Now, because like Vanos, it has been around for decades at this point, the oil level sensor has been around for a long time as well. Even older N-series engines had an oil level sensor, but over time it has changed in design. So they're not all the same. It is really important to get one specific for your platform. So for example, if you look up some old oil level sensor part numbers, you'll see a sensor that looks like this. But as it progressed even to later N-series engines, like ones that were in the F-series 328 and 335, it transformed a little bit and looks more like this. And then moving up to the B58, it went through another revision. Now you can see it's a slightly different length, but a lot of the shape seems to look pretty familiar. And then now on the TU engines, it's got an even completely different shape. So over the years, it has been revised, but primarily it serves the same function to tell you your oil level. Now, contrary to popular belief, it's not just like an electronic dipstick, which in my mind would kind of make sense. You know, it sticks out of the oil a little bit and it just has a way to sense where it's sitting in your oil pan and how high the oil is on that oil level sensor. But in reality, it's actually a tube. So oil can go into that tube, and that is how it can actually measure a lot of things. A lot of them can measure oil temperature, they measure the oil quality, and they can also, of course, measure the oil level. Now, I've seen a couple different ways that describe how these oil level sensors work, but again, from my research, the latest ones are using an ultrasonic measurement system. It uses an ultrasonic pulse that it sends out, and it measures the length of that wave as it reflects off of the oil surface, basically where the oil and the air meet. So along that line, the ultrasonic wave bounces back, and it's able to capture that wave and convert it to a digital signal. Now, the time that it takes for that process to happen and using that digital signal, it can convert it to an oil level measurement. And so that's really where it comes from. Now, it sounds really complicated because it is, and naturally all of those calculations they use to characterize the oil level requires more than just, you know, running it in any scenario. They need to have it at a certain oil pressure. Based on all the specs I've seen, it's around 3 bar. It also needs to have a specific oil temperature, so that's why you need to drive your car for a little while and get it up to temp before it can actually measure your oil level. And they also monitor a lot of other things like oil pressure and things like that. So all the characteristics of your oil need to be able to be measured in order for your oil level sensor to accurately calculate your oil level. Now, there are a couple different ways that you can measure the oil level with this sensor. There's one kind of dummy way where it can do it easily at any time. And then there's a more accurate way that it can measure with all of those conditions in place. So the first one is really the most useful, especially after you've done an oil change, or let's say you have an oil leak. You want to know when you start your car that it's safe to drive. And so that's the first one. They call it a qualitative measurement. And basically, it's just making sure that your oil is above the minimum level, but it isn't accurately measuring exactly where your oil level is. Now, above and beyond that, there's the actual quantitative measurement. So that's where you can get the discrete value that tells you exactly how much oil is in your engine. And so again, this requires to be at a specific oil pressure, oil temperature, you know, all of the conditions need to be met. You need to be on a level surface, and then you can actually manually start the oil level measurement in your iDrive. After you start it, you'll hear the engine rev up a little bit. You need to keep your foot off of the brake or the gas or anything. Your car just needs to be in park and let it do its own thing. And while it's holding the revs, it's going to go through the process of measuring your oil level. Now, once the process is done, it's going to show you a min and max level, and that oil should be somewhere in there, hopefully at the max point. But if it's in the middle or if it's low, keep in mind that this is only representing the last quart or liter of oil that you've added to your engine. So if it's at the minimum level, you need to add 1 liter or 1 quart oil, depending on your region and the units that you're using on your iDrive, in order to get it to the max level. So it's not the full 6.5 liters or whatever. I know some people see it halfway and they think, oh, I need to add 3 quarts of oil or something to get it back up to the max because it's halfway empty. That's not accurate. It's really only measuring that last quart or liter of oil that you would add to top off your engine. Now, I know a lot of you guys are concerned because it's a sensor, and like any other sensor, it can fail. So if there is a problem with the oil level sensor, you'll typically experience a couple different things. One is there are specific faults related to the oil level sensor. So if it has a short circuit, loses power, or anything like that, you will throw a code for that in your DME, and you can use basically any scan tool, ISTA, Bimmerlink, anything like that, to scan for codes, and it will show that as a problem. Another issue is sometimes people are just unable to get an oil level measurement. So when you try to start the more accurate oil level reading process, it will fail and it won't actually measure your oil level. So usually if that happens, the first thing people will do is replace the oil level sensor. Now, on the contrary, if it says that your oil level is low, some people will say, you know, are we sure that it's actually accurate? Could the oil level sensor be wrong or bad? But that's not how it works. It doesn't show that your oil level is low if your oil level sensor is messed up. So if it says it's low, that definitely means that you need to add oil. Whereas if there's an issue with it, you won't be able to read the oil level at all, or it'll just throw that DME code. Now, probably the biggest question I've been trying to understand is, how does a bad oil pump stop your oil level sensor from reading? Because that never made sense to me. But now that I understand how the oil level sensor works, it does make sense, because like I said, the oil pressure needs to be at a specific amount in order for the oil level reading to calculate accurately. And if it's outside of that range, then it's not going to work. I actually had somebody reach out to me after I posted my previous video talking about the B58TU oil pump issues, and they mentioned that they noticed if their oil pressure is above 47 PSI, it won't read. But if it's below 47 PSI, it seems to read fine. And that's because apparently there is a range of plus or minus 0.25 bar on that 3 bar requirement for your oil level to read accurately. So that means on the PSI scale, you know, as low as around 40 PSI or as high as around 47 PSI, within that range, you'll be able to get an accurate oil level reading. If it goes outside of that range, then either it won't start measuring it to begin with, or if the oil pressure rises while it's measuring, that can create the scenarios where it stops. Now, what it sounds like is most people are experiencing this as the engine gets higher in temperature. So maybe after driving your car, you know, 10 or 15 minutes, you're able to get an oil level reading. But after driving it for longer periods or beating on it, when you stop the car and try to measure it, you're not able to read it anymore. And what it seems like is as the oil temperatures get higher, your pressures also get higher. And so that can prevent it from being in that range. So now at idle, it might be at 48 or 49 PSI and your oil level won't read accurately anymore. Now, a lot of times if it gets really bad, it'll throw additional codes, and I'll post a link in the video description to a Bimmer Post thread where there are a lot of M340i owners kind of talking about their experience with this, but a lot of them, it ends up throwing a code and then they end up replacing their oil pump and it seems to address their issues. Other people just basically note that if their engine is really hot, they're not able to read their oil level, but if it's at that, you know, operating range where the oil pressure is okay, then they can read their oil level. So they just kind of keep monitoring it to see how those conditions span out over time. But it seems like it's not really based on the oil level sensor. It's really the oil pressure that your oil pump should be, you know, controlling and setting up into the right operating range that is preventing it from reading oil level accurately. So I know that's a lot of information, but hopefully this at least explains a little bit more about how the oil level sensor works and why a bad oil pump can prevent it from being able to read accurately. There are a lot of other things in the system that I'm sure work together with the Vanos and everything to make it all work properly. But I felt like this was kind of the base level information that was really key for me to understand how it worked and for you guys to have a better understanding of what's going on and why people have different experiences with trying to measure their oil level in B58 engines. So hopefully this answers all the questions you guys have, and I think that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you do have any other questions, leave them down below.